Hi, my name is Matt Frangakis, and I went on the Botswana missions trip of March 2019. This is my story. The Botswana missions trip was a 4-day long trip, arranged to visit an informal settlement located just west of Gaborone called Kumukwane. Not only was this my very first missions trip, but it was also the first time I had been outside of this country, and so I was understandably nervous. I had been very convicted about my lack of having been on a missions trip, and also just my evangelism in general in the months leading up to the missions trip. It's a challenge for me in the best of circumstances to evangelize, yet God calls us as Christians to evangelize. And so it's something that I really needed to get better at. I had no idea what to expect. No idea what to say to people, no idea how to go about evangelizing. I was worried that there would be a lot of pressure to convert people, and that if I didn't get people saved, that the trip would have been a waste. I was also scared of people's reactions to me. Would they reject me? Would they ask me questions that I couldn't answer? To give you some context of Kumukwane, in this settlement most people have heard of God, as there are quite a few religious sects located there. And so the challenge was not introducing people to God, but rather combating the heresies that have been preached there. And to do that, we obviously had to identify them first. And this was quite a challenge. We did door-to-door ministry, and so we went from door-to-door in groups of three, carrying a Christian newspaper called The Challenge. This newspaper was really just a way to strike up a conversation with someone. You can go up to them and say, "Hey, I have a newspaper for you." And then that opens the door for you to chat to them about the contents of the newspaper, which is mostly articles about people coming to Christ. That then is a stepping stone directly into the gospel. The first few places we went to, I just observed the two other people in my group. They had been on many missions trips before and had done door-to-door evangelism many times over. And so I learned a lot just by watching them. Then when I started doing what they were doing, God started teaching me some very important truths about evangelism. Firstly, it's not up to you to save the person. That is God's responsibility. All he asks you to do is to proclaim his word. If someone doesn't come to salvation right then and there, that's okay. That isn't the measure of success, but rather God can use those seeds that you plant in his own timing in the future at some point. Then the second thing that I learned is that evangelism is completely powered by the Holy Spirit. We don't have to do it in our own strength, and attempting to do it in our own strength is futile. God doesn't say to us, "Go make disciples," and then just deserts us. You know, he is there, he is always with us, and we could feel his presence with us. Then thirdly, most people are actually completely willing to sit down and listen to what you have to say. I was expecting people to just shut me down immediately, but that's actually not the case. By the end of that trip, my attitude had completely shifted. I was really looking forward to going out from door to door, whereas at the beginning I was like, "No, I can't do this." Coming out of this missions trip, I had learned that evangelism is actually substantially easier than we often think it is. We so often tend to put up these mental blocks that just make it more difficult for ourselves. Not only that, but missions trips are also a lot of fun. The group we had there was amazing, and I grew really close to each and every one there. There's nothing like sharing a common experience of being on a missions trip together that allows you to get to know people. We had quite a few young adults with us on that trip, and one of my fondest memories is just sitting around the campfire with everyone singing worship songs to the Lord. Then when the adults that were slightly older than us, when they went to bed, all the young adults would stay up and sit around the fire just chatting and laughing and watching shooting stars. It was so great. I mean, who said mission trips aren't fun? Yes, I think so, at least once. It really does force you to rely on God. And I mean, if you've ever needed a boost in your prayer life, this is it. If you're anyone like me, going on a missions trip is a huge step outside your comfort zone. But as Christians, we are called to take steps in faith. We can't live our faith out in a comfort zone the whole time. But going on a missions trip is a really good stepping stone because you're still with other Christians and you can learn a lot from them. So it's not like you're taking that step alone. Missions trips are very hard work. They're certainly not vacations, but they are extremely rewarding knowing that you're doing the Lord's work. You grow closer to other Christians and you get to see God's hand at work, which is truly an amazing experience.